Hello everyone, this is Sarthak Sharma. Welcome to Digimento Education. And in this video, we are discussing the 20 questions from the Arithmetic Ability section of the DSSSB Computer Science PGT examination, which was conducted on 26th July 2018. And in this video, we are going to discuss the numerical questions, that is the arithmetic ability questions, which were asked in this exam. And after this video, you would be able to solve all these questions, and plus you will know the correct method to approach these kinds of questions, because they are also important for other exams like IBPS, bank or RBI and other SSC exams as well. So you will know the correct approach to solve these questions. So let's begin this video, and here is our first question. So the first question is, you have to find the value of this expression. See friends, this expression looks very difficult to solve, and in these type of questions, there is always a chance that you have been given any expanded form of a formula. Like in this first expression, you can see that it is a square plus 2ab plus b square, and here it is you can say a square minus 2ab plus b square. So these are the expanded forms of a square, a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. So we will write it like this, 47.53 plus 42.47 whole square upon this will be we can use a as 138.25 and b as 38.25. So it will be 138.25 minus 38.25 whole square. So we can clearly see that this is 90 square and here it is 100 square, which comes out to be 81 upon 100 when we cancel the two zeros. And there is off. So by BODMAS rule, we will first solve the off and then we will come to this divide sign. So this will be into 1 upon 16.2 and divide by, see here there are 4 and 6, so 6 decimals in the numerator and 6 decimals in the denominator. So we can write it 16 into 25 upon 325 into 5, and here we have again we have off, so we will solve this also. First here is 6.5, so we can see that 325 into 2 is 650, so we can add two zeros here and 100 here, so this will cancel by 2 here and this by 50. 25 also we can cancel by 2, so and yes, so this comes out to be 16 upon 10. And here we can say that we can add a zero here, it will go by 2, and 1 zero we can cancel, so this comes out to be 1 by 20, and we can change it into multiply and reverse this here into 10 by 16, zero will cancel and this will come out to be 1 by 32. So our correct option here is 3, that is 1 by 32. So they will never ask you such a big calculation. There is always a chance you can use whether you have to use approximation method, or you can clearly see that like in this case this formula has been expanded, so you can use this also. Let's move on to question number 2 now. So question 2 is a word problem, and A is twice as efficient as B, and together they can do a work in as much time as C and D together take to do it. So let's assume that B does the whole work in B days. So A, as A is twice efficient as B, so A will take B by 2 days to complete the work, and from here we can find that B's 1 day work is 1 by B, and 1 day's work of A will be 2 by B, and they when they work together, they complete the work in the same time as C and D together take to do it. So we can here we can also calculate their 1 day's work. So 1 day's work of A and B together will also be equal to the 1 day work of C and D together. So 1 day's work of A and B will be 1 upon B plus 2 upon B, it will come out to be 3 by B. And we have this is given in the question that C does the work in 10 days and D does the work in 15 days. So the 1 day's work of C and D will be 1 by 10 plus 1 upon 15, and LCM would be 30 here. So this will come out to be 3 plus 2, that is 5 upon 30, or we can say 1 upon 6. So this should be equal. This is the 1 day's work of A and B together, and this is the 1 day work of C and D together. So we will equate them. 3 by B is equals to 1 by 6, and from here B comes out to be 18. So B will complete the work in 18 days, and we have to find in how many days can A alone do the work. So A does the work in B by 2 days, so A will do the work in 18 by 2 equals to 9 days. So here the correct answer is 3, that is option 3, that is 9. Okay, let's move on to question number 3 now. So question number 3 says a number consists of 2 digits. So let's assume a 2 digit number to be 10A plus B. B is the unit place digit, A is the tens place digit. So the digit at tens place exceeds the digit at units place by 4. So it is given in the question that A minus B is equals to 4. And the sum of digits is 1/7 of the number. So sum of the digits will be A plus B, and it is equal to 1 by 7 of the number, that is 10A plus B. So if we solve this, this will come out to be 7A plus 7B is equals to 10A plus B, and 6B equals to 3A, and from here we can say that A equals to 2B. So this comes out from our this equation, second equation, and we can put this in first equation to find A and B. So when we put this in the first equation, we find out that 2B minus B is equals to 4, or B is equals to 4. And when we put this again in the first equation, we will find that A comes out to be 8. So our number here is 10 into 8 plus 4, which is equals to 84. So the number is 84, and the question asks what is the remainder when the number is divided by the sum of the digits of the number. So the sum of the digits will be 8 plus 4 equals to 12, and we have to find the remainder when we divide 84 by 12, and this is completely divisible by 12. So our answer here is option 2, that is 0 remainder. Let's move on to question number 4. So question number 4 says 3 fractions are written in ascending order. Let's assume that our 3 fractions, or we can assume that as simple numbers as well, our 3 numbers are A, B and C. They are in the ascending order, that is A is the smallest of them and C is the largest of them. So it is given that if the largest fraction is divided by the smallest, that is when we divide C by A, it comes out to be 5 by 2. This is the first expression that we have, and which exceeds the middle fraction by 7 by 4. So the middle fraction, that is B, our middle number. So B is equals to 5 by 2 minus 7 by 4. So this will come out to be, this will here will be 4 and 3. So B is 3 by 4. So we surely know that B is equals to 3 by 4. Now if the sum of these 3 fractions is 1/11 by 12. So this is also given that A plus B plus C is equals to 1/11 by 12. We can write this like 23 by 12. Yes, 23 by 12. So we can put directly B from here, and we can put the value of C in form of A from this expression. C equals to 5A by 2. So we can find now A from here. A plus B is 3 by 4, and we put the value of C in the form of A only. So 5A plus 2 is equals to 23 by 12. So this comes out to be, when we add these two A terms, so this will be 7A by 2, and this will be here 23 by 12 minus 3 by 4, and when we take the LCM, 12, this comes out to be 23 by 9, that is 14. So 7a by 2 is equals to 14 by 12. We cancel it by 6. We cancel it by 2 and these by 3. So a comes out to be 1 by 3. And from here c comes out to be 5 by 2 into 1 by 3, that is equals to 5 upon 6. So we have all the three fractions or numbers, we can say a, b and c. So what we have to find, we have to find the difference between the largest and the smallest fractions. So the largest number is c, that is 5 by 6, and smallest number is a, that is 1 by 3. So this comes out to be 6 will be LCM, 5 minus 2, that is 3 by 6 or 1 by 2. So the answer is option 3 or 1 by 2. Let's move on to question number 5. So question number 5 says income of A is equals to 70% income of B. So we can write that, let's take AI as the income of A. It is equals to 0.7 into BI, that is income of B, and expenditure of A is equals to 60% of B's expenditure. So expenditure of A is equals to 0.6 or 60% of B's expenditure, BE. And also it is given that if A's expenditure is equal to 50% of B's income, so this is given that AE is equals to 0.5 BI. So from after putting AE in this equation, we can find the relation between BI and BE. So we can say that 0.5 BI is equals to 0.6 BE. Now what we have to find? We have to find the ratio of savings of A to that of B. So savings are total income minus expenditure. So the ratio of the savings of A and B will be equals to AI minus AE upon BI minus BE. So from here we can write that 0.7 BI minus 0.6 BE upon BI minus BE. So if we write from here, BI is equals to 6 by 5 BE. So we can put the value of BI in the form of BE from this equation, from to this equation, and then we can solve this question easily. So this will come out to be 0.7 into, so we can clearly see that after putting this, these B's will be cancelled out. So we are excluding them from beginning only. So 0.7 into 6 by 5 minus 0.6 upon 6 by 5 minus 1. So this will come out to be 7 into 6 is 42. So 0.42 minus 4.2 minus 3.0 upon, this will be 6 minus 5 equals to 1, and the 5 in the denominator will be cancelled out. So this will come out to be 1.2 upon 1, or we can say that this is 12 by 10 or 6 by 5. So our answer here is option 3, that is 6 is to 5. And friends, here are some courses which we have created for you. These include GATE, CSE-IT and UGC-NET, and placement preparation and competitive programming. And there are some new courses for DSSSB and KVS PGT TGT teacher, as well as UPPSC LT grade teacher recruitment as well. So we are covering all the technical examinations which occur throughout the year. And if you want to take our courses, then you can call us on the given contact number, that is 9821876104, and you can use 02 in place of 04, or you can contact us at the given email ID, that is admin@gatelectures.com. So friends, these are comprehensive courses having the full coverage of the syllabus, and they will definitely help you to prepare and score better in your examinations. And now let's move on to question number 6. Okay, so question number 6 is a simplification. question, we have to simplify this expression. So we will write this in the form of the lowest prime numbers. So 49 is 7 square. So we will write it as 7 to the power 2 and by 2 it's given into 512 is 2 to the power 9. So we can write it 2 to the power 9 and divided by 0.25 is 1 by 4. So this will be 2 to the power 9 by 4 into this here is 8. 8 is 2 to the power 3 by 4. So this will be 2 to the power 3 by 4 into 729. So 729 is 3 to the power 6. So we will write it 3 to the power 6 into 2 to the power 3. And this is in this is after divide. So we will use this in the denominator in multiplication. So we are excluding it for now. And 343 is 7 to the power 3. So we can write it 7 to the power 3 by 3 into 256 is 2 to the power 8. So we can write it 2 to the power 8 and into 0.375. So we can write it 375 by 1000, and when we divide it by 125, it comes out to be 3 by 8. So we will write it into minus 3 by 8 in power, and into 81 is 3 to the power 4. So this will be 3 to the power 4 by 2 because we have 0.5 here, and in multiplication now we will use this. So 64 is 2 to the power 6. So we will write 2 to the power 6 into 4 by 3. So let's now simplify this. So this is 7 and this is also 7 because these powers cancel out. So 7 is cancelled totally. We can add 2 to the power 9 by 4 into 2 to the power 3 by 4. So we will add 9 by 4 and 3 by 4, which will come out to be 12 by 4. Or we can write it 2 to the power 12 by 4 or 2 to the power 3, 12 by 4 into this cancels out. So this will become 3 to the power 4 upon, so see, this will be 2 to the power minus 3. So we will take this to numerator and write 2 to the power 3. We will cancel the minus sign here. And this is 3 to the power 4 by 2. So we will write it 3 square into this is 2 to the power 6 into 4 by 3. So this cancels out by 2 and this becomes 2 to the power 8. So again, adding the powers of same number 2 to the power 3 and 2 to the power 3 again. So this becomes 2 to the power 6 into 3 to the power 4 upon 3 square into 2 to the power 8. This comes out to be 3 square upon 2 square, that is 9 by 4. And when we divide this, we will get the answer 2.25. So our correct answer here is option 4, that is 2.25. Let's move on to question number 7. So question number 7 is from compound interest, and the question says the compound interest on a sum at 15% per annum. So rate is 15% and end of 3 years. So time is 3 years and compound interest is given to us. It is equals to 4167. Then the interest, when the interest is compounded annually, so what will be the simple interest on the same sum at the same rate and the same time period? So first we can calculate from here, from the formula of compound interest, CI is equals to P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power T or N minus 1. So this is the formula of CI. We will put the values here. 4167 is equals to P into 1 plus 15 by 100 cube, because we are calculating it for 3 years, minus 1. So this is 3 by 20. So we can write down that 4167 is equals to P into, and this comes out to be 23 upon 20 cube minus 1. So we will have to calculate this. 20 cube is 8000 and 23 square, we know that 23 square is 529, and we will multiply it by 23. So this will be 7, 3 into 2 is 6, 8. This here will be 15. Okay, so this will be 7, 6, and here it will be 1 to 167. Okay, so we will write down 4167 is equals to P into, and this will be 12167 upon 8000 minus 1. So when we will take the LCM, we can clearly see that 4167 will come in numerator, which will cancel out. So our P comes out to be 8000 from here. Now we can calculate the simple interest on it for 3 years. So simple interest is equals to P into R into T upon 100. So P is 8000, rate is 15, and time is 3 upon 100. So this comes out to be 80 into 45, which is equals to 3600. Yes, 3600. So the correct answer here is option 1, that is 3600. Let's move on to question number 8. So question number 8 is from average, and it says that the average of 8 numbers is 64. So we know that the sum of the numbers, sum upon total number of terms, is equals to average. So we can find the sum total of all these 8 numbers from here. So their sum will be equals to average, that is 64 into 8, which is equals to 512. The average of first 2 is 53. So we can find the sum of first 2. Let's take the numbers as n1, n2 up to n8. So we know that n1 plus n2 will be equals to 53 into 2, which is equals to 106, and the average of next 3 is 68. So we can find the sum of n3, n4 and n5 as well, which will be equals to 68 into 3, which is equals to 4 and 204. So we have the sum of now we can find the sum of first 5 numbers from here, which will be equals to 310. This will be equals to 310. Now the average of the sixth number is 4 greater than seventh number. So this is given to us that n6 minus n7 is equals to 4, and the sixth number is 4 greater than 7 and 5 less than 8 number. So n8 minus n6 is equals to 5. This is also given. So what is the average of 6th and 8th numbers? So for this we will have to find the 6th and 8th number. So what we can do here is we can write n7 in form of n6. So n7, we can write that n7 is equals to n6 minus 4 and n8, that is 8th number, is equals to n6 plus 5. So we have the total sum here. We can write that 512 is equals to sum of these first 5 numbers, which will be equals to 310 plus n6 plus n7, which is equals to n6 minus 4 plus n8, which is equals to n6 plus 5. So from here it will come out to be 2. This will come out to be 202. 202 is equals to 3n6 plus 1. So 3n6 comes out to be 201, and we can write that n6 is equals to 67. N6 is equals to 67, and 8th number was 5 more than the n6. So we have to find the average of 6th and 8th number. So we can directly put here 67 is n6, and n8 will be equals to 67 plus 5 upon 2 for average. For so this will come out to be cancel out. So 67 plus 2.5, which is equals to 69.5. So our answer should be option 3, that is 69.5. Let's move on to question number 9. So question number 9 says Nakul starts his journey from a place A and Sukil starts his journey from a place B towards each other. So N, that is Nakul, and S, that is Sukil, are moving towards each other. Let's assume that this point here is A and this point here is B, and Nakul starts his journey from this side and Sukil starts his journey from this side. Okay, if the speeds of Nakul and Sukil are 16 km per hour, so speed of Nakul is 16 and that of Sukil is 25. It is given to us respectively, and time taken by Nakul to reach B after crossing Sukil on the way is 3/8, that is 25/8 hours. Okay, so if this is the path between A and B, let's assume that Nakul and Sukil they cross each other at point C. So the time taken by Nakul to reach B from C, this time here is 25/8 hours. So then how much time in hours will Sukil take to reach A after crossing Nakul? So friends, there is a direct formula to solve this kind of questions. The formula is S1 square into T1, that is the speed of A, and T1 is the time taken by A to reach B from C, is equals to S2 square into T2, that is the S2 is the speed of B and T2 is the time taken by the B to reach A from C. So from here we can put the values 16 into 16 into T1 is 25/8 is equals to S2 is 25. So 25 into 25 and into T2, which we have to find. So this cancels out by 2. This cancels out, 25 cancels 25, so T2 comes out to be 32/25, or the correct answer here should be 17/25. So friends, this is the correct answer, the answer given in the official key, that is option A. There is a misprint here, this is wrong answer. Correct answer is 17/25. So let's move on to question number 10 now. So question number 10 says a hollow sphere of outer radius 12 cm is cut into two equal hemispheres. So let's make our hemisphere here. So if let's say this is our hemisphere and it is a hollow hemisphere, so there are two radius to it. Now the outer radius will be 12 because it is made out of a sphere, hollow sphere of radius 12 centimeters. So we know the outer radius should be 12. The total surface area of one hemisphere is 14362/7 centimeter square. So this is the total surface area of this hemisphere. So we know the formula for the total surface area of the sphere. So total surface area of this hemisphere should be 2 pi capital R square, where capital R is the outer radius, plus 2 pi into small r square. Small r is the radius of the inner sphere, the hollow one, and plus we will also add this part here in the total surface area. This will come out to be this is a circle, two circles, so pi r square minus pi r square. This should be the total surface area of this hemisphere, which should be equals to 14362/7. So we can calculate this here. First we will multiply this. 2 will come here, 5 and 7 4 28 0 3, and this should be 10052, and add 2, so this comes out to be 10054/7. So let's put the values. So this will be, so we can add this term and this term here, so this will become 2 3 pi into, we know the outer radius, it is 12 square, plus when we'll add these two, it will come out to be pi into small r square, and this should be equals to 10054/7. So when we take pi common from here, or 22/7 common from here, this will be 3 into 144 plus r square, and it is equals to 10054/7. So this 7 cancels out, and this will also cancel out, 11 into 2, and this will be 9 1 and 4. So this cancels out again, 2 into 4 5, 7. So now 3 into 144 is equals to 432. So now we have 432 plus r square is equals to 457, and from here we will get r square is equals to 25, or r, that is our inner radius, should be equals to 5 centimeters. So the correct answer here is option 1, that is 5 centimeters. Let's move on to question number 11. So question number 11 says a shopkeeper labeled the price of an article so as to earn a profit of 30% on its cost. So the market price, marked price of this article is 1.3 times its CP, that is given to us. So we'll write MP is equals to, it is 100, 1 plus 30% of CP, it will be equals to 1.3 into CP. Now he then sold it by offering a discount of X percent on the labeled price. So he offers a discount of X percent on the labeled price or the marked price of it. So the selling price of this article will be equals to 1 minus X upon 100, which is our discount, into its marked price, or we can directly write 1.3 CP. So this is our selling price. If his actual profit is equals to 17%, then the value of X is. So we have to find the value of X if the actual profit is 17%. So from here we can clearly see that this here is the actual profit of the shopkeeper. So 1 minus X upon 100 into 1.3 is equals to 17%, or 17% profit will be equals to 1.17. So now this will become 1.3 minus 1.3 x upon 100 is equals to 1.17. So this will go here, it will become 0.13. yes, 0.13 is equals to 1.3 x upon 100, and this will cancel out, so x comes out to be 10. So our the value of X was 10, that is option 3 is our correct answer here. Let's move on to question number 12. So question number 12 says, let X be the least multiple of 17, which leaves a remainder 2 in each case when divided by any of the numbers 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. So we have to find the least number which, when divided by 4 or 6 or 8, 10, 12 or 14, any of them, it leaves a remainder 2. So this will be equals to the LCM of 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14 plus, and we will add 2 in it. So you can calculate the LCM of 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. I have already calculated it. LCM of these numbers comes out to be 840. So we have to add 2 in it because the number always leaves a remainder of 2. So our number X becomes 840 into K. K is any integer, we can change the values of 1 K to 1, 2, 3, 4 to find our answer, plus 2. So this is our number here, X is equals to 840K plus 2. Now X be the least multiple of 17. So we also know that this X number is a multiple of 17. So friends, now this is a very lengthy question. What you have to do is you have to put the values of K and check if it is value of X is completely divisible by 17 or not. Like when you will put the value of K equals to 1, so X will come out to be 842. So then you will have to check whether 842 is divisible by 17 or not. So it is not divisible by 17, then you will put value of K equals to 2, then X will come out to be 840 into 2 will be 1680 and plus 2, so it will be 1682. This is again not a multiple of 17, so you will have to check further. I have calculated, and it comes out to be that when K is equals to 7, then the value of X will become 5882, and this is completely divisible by 17. So our correct answer here is x equals to 5882. We have to find the sum of digits of x. So the sum of digits will be 5 plus 8 plus 8 plus 2. It will be equals to 18 plus 5, that is equals to 23. So hence our correct answer here is option 4, that is 23. Let's move on to question number 13. So question number 13 is a question of simplification. You have to simplify this expression here. So we'll write it down like this. 6 1 by 2 is equals to 13 by 2 minus, here is the first bracket, and 2 by 5, we'll change this divide into multiply. This will become 5 by 6 plus again a bracket, this is 7, and we will change this divide into multiply, and this will come out to be 4 by 7. And in the denominator, 6 2 by 3 is equals to 20 by 3, and we'll change this divide again to multiply, so this will become 2 by 5. It will be multiplied by 3, 3 by 4, so it will come out to be 15. 15 by 4, and then this here is divide. We'll first calculate off according to the board mass rule. So this will be 3 into 2 is 6, 7 by 3 off into 20 into 7 by 6. So this here is our full expression. So this here will cancel out, this will be 1 by 3, and this also cancels out, so it will become 13 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 4, and in the denominator it will become 20 by 3 into 2 by 5 into 15 by 4. We will change this divide into multiply, so it will become into 3 upon 7 into 20 into 7 by 6. So there are further 7 cancels 7, this 20 cancels this 20 here, and 3 into 2 is 6, and 5 into 3 is 15, so these all cancels out, and it comes out to be only 1 by 4 remains in the denominator. So in the numerator we will take LCM, this will become 6 is the LCM, and it will be 39 minus 3 into 2, so it will be 2 here, 2, and then minus 4 into 6, that is 24. So this will become, this here will be 39 minus 2 is 37, and minus 24 is 13, so this will be 13 by 6, and there was 1 upon 4 in the denominator, so it will come in numerator. This will cancel out by 2 and 3, so this becomes 26 by 3, or we can write it 8 2 by 3. So our correct answer here is option 2, that is 8 2 by 3. Let's move on to question number 14. So question number 14 says, when each of 3092, 4103, 5451 is divided by the greatest number A, the remainder in each case is B. So this is also a standard question. In this question, what we'll have to do, we have to find the difference of all these three numbers, and the HCF of those three differences will be equals to the greatest number A. So these three numbers will be 4103 minus 3092. Second number will be 5451 minus 4103, and third number will be 5451 minus 3092. So first we have to calculate these three differences. I have already calculated them. They comes out to be 1011, 1348 and 2359. So the HCF of these three numbers will be equals to A. So let's find out their HCF by the division rule. So this will be 1348 here by 1, so this comes out to be here 7 3 3 3 3 7, and here it is 1011, so this goes by 3, 1011, so here we find 337, and when we divide 2359 by 337, that it completely divides it by 7. 2359. So our HCF here is 337. So the value of A is equals to 337, and the remainder in each case is B. So we have to find, we have to divide any of these numbers by 337 to find the value of B. So when we divide 3092 by 337, this comes out to be the remainder, comes out to be, it will go by 9 here, and this will come out to be 3033. So the remainder will be 59. So the value of B is 59 and the value of A is 337. So what is the value of A plus B? We have to find the value of A plus B, that is 337 plus 59, and this will be equals to 693. So our correct answer is 396. So option 4 is the correct answer. Let's move on to question number 15. So this question number 15 is a graph question. We have to see this graph and calculate the answer of this question. So let's read our question. The question says, if the total number of students in all the 6 schools was 15800, so the total number of students is 15800 for these 7 schools here, for these 6 schools here, and there are percentage given in it, like A has 25% of 15800, B has 12% of 15800, and so on. So the total number of students is 15800. Then by what percent the number of students in school A of age above 10 years, so these here is the distribution of students, and here is the this is misprint here, and this here is the percentage of students whose age is 10 years or less. So if in A 40% students are below 10 years or below 10 years, then obviously 60% are above 10 years. So the number of students in school A, so first let's calculate the number of students in school A. This will be equals to, so we can see here A has 25% of 15800, so 25 upon 100 into 15800, and we have to find the number of students in school A of age above 10 years. So in A 40% students are below, percentage of students below 10 years, so obviously 60% will be above 10 years, so we'll multiply it by 60 by 100. So this is the our first expression. So was more than the number of students in school E. So in school E, we have 15% of the total students having age less than or equal to 10 years. So in E, 60% students have age 10 years or less. So our second expression will be 15 by 100 into 15800 again into 60 by 100. So either you can calculate all of them, or we can take the ratio, because we have to find this first expression is how much percentage more than this second percent, this second expression. So we can clearly see that these all cancels out, and the ratio comes out to be 5:3. So 5 minus 3 upon 3 into 100, this is what we have to find. It comes out to be 200 upon 3, which is equals to 66 2 by 3 percent. So the correct answer here is option 3, that is 66 into 2 by 3 percent. Let's move on to question number 16. So question number 16 says, if the number of students in B and C together in 2008 was 4500, so if we add B and C, it comes out to be 30%. So 30%, 30 by 100 of X is equals to 4500. This cancels out, and X becomes 15,000. So the total strength of students now becomes 15,000 in place of 15800, which was in the last question. So our total strength now is 15000. What will be the difference between the number of students in D? So the number of students in D are 16 percent of 15000, the number of students in D above 10 years. So in D above 10 years will be 100 minus 55 is equals to 45 by 100 minus we have to find the difference, and that in F below or equal to 10 years age. So we can see F here is 14%. So 14 by 100 into 15000 into below or equal to 10 years. So in F below and equal to 10 years are 70% students. So this will be 70 by 100. So we have to calculate this now. So this cancels out here, this cancels out here, and 100 100. So and here we can see that 100 cancels out, this 10 cancels out, this by 5, and this goes by this by 3, and here 2, and this goes by 8. So this is 8 into 3 is 24. So this will be 24 into 45 minus 15 into 7 is 105 into 14. So this is what we have to find out. Obviously this is in the modulus because it is not given which one is greater than. So this can also come out to be in minus sign. So 24 into 45 will be equals to 10. This will come out to be 1080 minus 1470, and this will be equals to minus 390. So our answer here is minus 390, or we have to find only the difference. So our answer here is option 2, that is 390. Let's move on to question number 17. So question number 17 and also question number 18 are based on this graph here. So this graph shows the production of crude oil by different countries in 2005 and 2006. This line represents 2005 and this line represents 2006. So let's read our question. The production of crude oil by countries A and F together in 2006. So in 2006, the production of crude oil by countries A and F. So in 2006, A's production is 12 and F's production is 10. So the total production of A and F comes out to be 22. In 2006, is X percent less than the total production of crude oil by B, C and D together in 2005. So we have to find that total production of B, C and D in 2005. So this comes out to be 11 plus 12 plus 8. So this comes out to be 31. So it is of A and F, and this here is the total production of B, C and D in 2005. So we have to find 22%. 22 is how much percent less than 31. So this will be 31 minus 22 upon 31 into 100, which is equals to 9 upon 31 into 100. So friends, this comes out to be around 30% only. So the answer given in the key, that is 20 is not the correct answer. This is the official key and the answer given is wrong. The correct answer should be approximately 30%. Let's move on to question number 18. So question number 18 says the number of countries in which the amount of production of crude oil in 2006 was more than 20% as compared to the production in 2005. So as you can clearly see here, only A, B and D are the three countries for which the production of crude oil in 2006 is greater than 2005. So we have to check in these three countries whether the production in 2006 is greater than more than 20% as compared to the production in 2005, or we can say it is greater than 1.2 into the production in 2005. So we have to check this condition here. So is 12 more than 1.2 into 9? So 12 into 9 is 108. So 12 is obviously greater than 10.8. So this is correct. Let's check for B also. So is 14 greater than 1.2 into 11? So is 14 greater than 13.2? So this is also correct. Now let's check the for D, country D. So is 9 greater than 1.2 into 8? So no, this is not correct. This comes out to be 9.6, and 9 is not greater than 9.6. So there are only two countries, country A and country B, for which production in 2006 is greater than, more than 20% as compared to the production in 2005. So again, this also, the answer given in official key is wrong. 3 is not the answer. The correct answer should be option 4, that is two countries. Let's move on to question number 19. So question number 19 and 20 are based on this graph here. This graph represents the number of units exported by various companies A, B, C, D and E in the year 2015, represented by this color, and 2016. Okay, so now let's read our question number 19. So total number of units of C and E type vehicles exported in 2016. So 2000, if we are talking about 2016, so C exports 32.5 and E exports 22.5. so the total number of units of C and E type vehicles exported is equals to 32.5 plus 22.5. It comes out to be 55. Is what percent more than that of D type vehicle exported in 2015? So D exported 30 units in 2015. So we have to find 55 minus 30 upon 30 into 100. So this will come out to be 25 upon 3 into 10, that is 250 upon 3, and it comes out to be 83/3. So the correct answer is option 2, that is 83/3. Let's move on to question number 20. So question number 20 says the average number of units of A, B and D type vehicle exported in 2015. So for 2015, A exported 27, B exported 22.5 and C exported 27.5 units. We have to find for D. So this will not be here. For D, there are 30 units in 2015. So when we'll add them, this will come out to be 0.5, 9 and 7, 79.5, and we have to find the average of it. So we'll divide it by 3 and it will come out to be 26.5. okay, so now we have to find this 26.5 is how much less than that of A, B and E type vehicles exported in 2016. So we have to calculate for A, B and E in 2016. So this will be 30, this here 30 and 33 and 22.5. so 30 plus 33 plus 22.5. so when we'll add them, this will come out to be 5 here, and this will be 5 and 8. So this will come out to be 85.5, and when we'll divide it by 3 for the average, this will come out to be 28.5. so we have to find 26.5 is x percent less than 28.5. we have to find the value of x, so we can calculate it by using 28.5 minus 26.5 upon 28.5 into 100. So this will be 2 upon 28.5 into 100. So when you will calculate it, this will come out to be 7.0175. so this is approximately, we have to find nearest to an integer, so it is nearest to 7. So the correct answer should be option A, that is 7. So friends, these were the 20 questions from the arithmetic ability section of the DSSSB Computer Science PGT examination of 26 July 2018. And I would say the level of questions asked was moderate to difficult. There were difficult questions as well. Plus the calculations were very lengthy. So there were lengthy calculations. So obviously the cutoff for this section would be low. And friends, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if this video was helpful for you, then please like this video, share this video with your friends, and please subscribe to our channel. So friends, thank you very much and have a very nice day.